Come on over here. Gary U.S. Bonds.
That was fun, baby.
That was fun.
That was fun.
Man, you look good. You sound good.
But thank you, my friend.
How are you, all right?
I'm doing great.
You're doing great. You look terrific. You look like $1 million.
Oh, my God. You need glasses. Somebody bring in glasses, too.
Well, you know, we got a great makeup artist. And that's a trick for both of us.
Yeah.
Vivian, she's good, isn't she?
Oh, she's... Look at this.
look at what she did. Brand new book out. That's My Story.
Yeah,
I love it.
I can write.
He can write. And I told you before, I bought this. I mean, I didn't even get it free. I bought it.
Oh, no. We weren't going to send it to you.
I know that. And that's why I did it.
Because we know you're cheap.
My ex-wife told you that. But I love the book.
Oh, thank you. I absolutely love the book.
What's compelling right from the beginning is little Stephen Van Zandt writes the foreword to it.
Yeah, he did. He did. I love Steve.
He talks about a time where he was very disenchanted with the music business, and he had broken his finger, and he was off for a little while.
Yeah.
And then he came across you, and that changed. He got the fire again because of you.
Oh, good, good.
You know, I
wish I could do it again.
Yeah, but you've transcended so much music.
Well, we've done this a couple of times. Look, I've been an oldie but a goodie twice now.
I know that.
You know,
legendary status.
I know. I'm starting to get a little scared about this now.
But you do a great job. But what I love the part of the book. When you talk about it, you're on tour your very first time. Your mom takes you on the road. You're with Sam Cooke and B.B. King.
Sam Cooke and B.B. King.
Right.
Laverne Baker, Ruth Brown, Mom's Mabel.
Mom's Mabel,
was on there too. Yeah.
What are you talking about, boy?
But you're on that tour, and at that time you're just starting out, and you're in the bus, and then one day, Sam Cooke and B.B. King say, "You don't move."
Yeah, they got me. They're riding in the car. They got a limo, you know. We're riding the bus, the peons. So they said, "Come with us." I go, "What do you mean?" "Today, when we leave here, you get in the car. You're riding with us."
Yeah.
Right. You know.
Riding with the king.
Y'all drinking liquor in there? So anyway, I get in and they cream me, you know. They said, "You know what, you're not doing it right." You know, so you're a good looking kid. He said, "You got all, you know, you can be something big, but you get on stage and you don't say anything." It's in backstage and you're like all over the place and you're laughing and joking and telling all these stories and stuff. But you walk on stage and you're like, you're dead.
You got nothing.
So get out there and do it. And I didn't do it for like two or three shows until one day when I got off the stage and I'm walking back and I'm smiling because I just thought I did a nice show. And I get to the edge of the stage and Sam Cooke like, bam! Oh, wow, why is he hitting on me like this? He says, "Come in the dressing room." And they went into me like nothing, man, you know? And says, "Next time, you go out on that stage, you start talking and you start moving around and you start being, working with the crowd." And I did.
And you did?
Yeah, he slapped me upside my head. I didn't want that to happen.
That was,
I'll talk to anybody. "Hey, how you doing?" I was talking to people at the hotel. You know?
I absolutely love the fact that you're open. You're such a music aficionado. You love music. You love the passion of it.
Oh yeah.
You love the soul of it. Very few people know that you're a tremendous songwriter. But the chance meeting came in 1980. Little Stephen Van Zandt sets up a meeting.
Yeah.
And in 71, you didn't know who he was. Bruce Springsteen shows up.
Yeah. Yeah. I was in Jersey here somewhere. I think it was Hazlitt.
Hazlitt. You probably had to drive in.
Well. No. I was at the place that they had an airplane on top.
Yeah. Airport Plaza.
Okay.
There you go.
Either it was GFK. I don't remember which one. And I was in there, and the guy walked in. Two guys walked in with this guy. And I'm standing on stage, and you could see everybody in the audience, you know, from the stage there. And so he came over to me. He says, "Hey, look, I got a buddy of mine who would like to come up and sing a song with you." Oh, okay. And I said, I'll be fine, you know. And I figured I can go to the bar and get a beer while this idiot gets up there and does half of my show for me, you know. And I said, well, give me his name. He gave me his name. And I says, okay, ladies and gentlemen, we got a young man out here in the audience, and I'd like to bring him up to sing some songs for you, you know. And I know you're going to like him. And please, please give him a round of applause. His name is Bruce Springsteen. They went wild. And I'm standing at the mic going, who the hell is this? Who is this guy? And he gets up there and he gets my guitar and he starts playing. He goes, we're going to sing this song. He did, him and I together, we did about an hour and a half together. You know, it was one of the greatest nights that I ever had, you know. And I got a chance to, I got free beer after
you
that.
You got a free beer after that. And then as a result of that, a great album came out, Dedication came out.
Yeah, but that was a couple of years later
we
did it, because he was doing his album at the time. And he called me up and he said, I got a song that I'm doing and it sounds so much like you, man. He said, why don't you come over to the studio and listen to this thing, you know? And that was the Dedication.
Yeah.
And I go, wow, that does sound like the quarter to three type stuff. And it was great.
Well,
and then we did an album after that, and you know, and you bought it.
But you, like you said, you were an oldie but a goodie, but twice. But that was that had to be phenomenal. But you to be open to that. There's a lot of guys that say, no, I'm going to stay true to my stuff, and you just seem to be open to a lot of things. And I like
all kinds of music. I don't care what it is, as long as it's fun, as long as it's happy, as long as I'm not giving a message and I'm not endorsing anybody. Nowadays, I don't want to do that at all. But
I know.
But as long as it's a happy, happy statement, I'll do it. And Bruce writes and sings great music, and that's what I like. And that's what
and
I like.
And you do it. And you still do stuff. You're in the studio. You've got new stuff out.
Yeah.
You got a brand new song. And I think this song was terrific.
Yeah.
It's called That's My Story. It's your story in a synopsis.
In three minutes and 40 something seconds, it tells the whole story in the book. And you can, if you can't read, you can listen to the song, and it's everything that's in the book almost.
Most of it.
You can dance while you're doing
and
it.
I've heard the song, of course, several times, and I love it.
Yeah.
But you can get Gary's book at GaryUSBonds.com.
Yeah.
You can get his book on there, and. I'm so glad you're here.
Why,
would you do
so
that's
much.
That's my story?
Of course I do.
Man, I love it.
That's my
Gary
job.
Gary U.S. Bonds, ladies and gentlemen. Get up here and start singing.